Good afternoon, coaches. It's always my pleasure to make some clinic in front of FIBA Europe. And for today, we choose our organization committee, we choose to talk about penetration, about moving without the ball. It's a topic which is so important for all the level of players, because it doesn't matter if you're talking about mini basket or top European players or NBA players. Drive and kick, penetration and kick, or moving without the ball is one of basic fundamentals. Because most of the time, it's important to teach kids, because all of them, when we are saying basketball, they are thinking about dribble, ball handling, passing, shooting. But if let's think like this, is more for you than for coaches. Let's think that we have two teams who are playing 40 minutes. If we divide minutes in equal time, let's say that one player is 4 minutes during the game is with ball, 36 minutes is without. So we should teach our players what to do, how to behave, and what to do to be ready in the moment to receiving, how to score. It's so important to teach them on each level, because in the end of every set offense, in the end of every set defense, they should move without the ball, because we have drive, we have movement without the ball before how to get open. So it's so important to teach them, and for us as a coaches, when all offenses are going to be over, when opponent coach is making good scouting on how our players are not going to execute well set offenses or whatever, in youth program also fast break, we always have drive and kick, movement without the ball. So it's so important to teach them what to do, how to read defense, and how to react on specific movement of the defense. Another stuff which is very interesting, and I'm always using when I'm talking about this topic, I find some documentary movie in America, in NBA, about movement without the ball. And 2 years ago, Klay Thompson, probably one of the best shooters in NBA, when he scored, if you remember, in semifinal game of the conference, 63 points against Oklahoma. They find out that to score 63 points, he had 1 minute and 10 seconds possession of the ball. So for 1 minute and 10 seconds, ball in his hands, he scored 63 points. So from 11 free-point shots, he scored 9 free-point shots, just catch and shot. What's mean this? That his moves without the ball was so good that in the moment of the receiving, he was completely free to shoot. After that, it's how to score. This is another stuff. You should sleep with ball, shoot every day, 1,000 shots to score. But how to prepare situation when you are without the ball to score, this is my topic, and I'm going to spend more time about that. So it's so important to understand for you that also players on the top level who are very good, they are moving well without the ball. Probably two best teams, I hope you are looking, you are watching EuroLeague games, Real Madrid, Fenerbahce, excellent. Excellent in drive and kick. San Antonio Spurs, YouTube, 2014-15 playoff, check the game, San Antonio series, San Antonio Miami, you will see 9-10 drives before to find free player to shoot. This is so difficult for defense, and your job when you are offensive player is to make difficult life for defense. So doing the right things in offense, you will have a lot of possibilities to score. Okay, let's start here to explain basic situation, because moving without the ball is not just a kick. We have a lot of aspects, a lot of situation in basketball, how to move without the ball and what to do in order to be ready, in order to, in moment to receive, on receivement to score. Okay, let's make some simple situation. We need just 10 players and one ball, just to explain the situation. Come on, let's go. Let's go. Big guys stay under the basket. Who is going to guard? Red, one from red guys go to drive to, okay, go to play defense on him. Let's go you. Okay, just change the colors. I want to be clear for the coaches, okay? Point guard here with ball. Let's be lady you. Be you with ball. Play defense on her. Come on, one shooter over there. Defense on him. Okay, one here. Okay, and let's say one in the corner over there. Okay, okay, you stay over there. Let's go in the corner. Maybe we need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so first situation which we have, one should be out, guys. One offense, one defense. Sit down over there. First situation, because in today basketball, also in top level, you can see a lot of situations that players, positions 2 and 3, they don't know how to get open. Why? Because they are only waiting for screens. So basic of basketball is 101. 101 means 101 with ball and 101 without the ball. So first of all, we should teach them, because how many times you can see also in Euroleague, shooters staying in the corner waiting for diamonds, can say, come on, okay, do something by yourself, get open by yourself, and after that, if you cannot receive the ball, you can use screen, because screen is second stuff, especially in under 14. So we should start from individual technique and tactic what to do. Okay, let's see this first situation. This player here, one pass away from the ball with big player on his side. So that means that he has limited space to get open, limited spacing. He cannot do from this situation backdoor cut because player is here. I might points for kids. So how, first of all, we should look what defender can do. You are defender over there. How you will play defense if I'm here? Okay, so tell me, show me some situation. Okay, situation one. With hand on the passing line. Then I defense with hand on the passing line. What I should do? I should teach my players how they should read. This is connected with previous topic, read and react. Three situations, first of all, to explain to you. So one situation when defender is with hand on the passing line. Another one is when he is full deny with hand and leg on the passing line. And another situation when he is staying here, let's say in today, basketball, some coaches, we call this open deny stance. Okay, let's start from this. Open deny stance, first of all, I should receive the ball, he should receive the ball in his shooting range. Biggest mistake, especially in youth program, those days we work on that here with Belgian players, what they are doing? They are starting to get open from the 3-point level, and after that they're going to receive the ball here. We don't want players to receive the ball here, because even in older group, they cannot score. From here, they are nothing. So from here, probably you can score, but from here, very difficult. So if you are shooter for 3 points, let's think that he can score for free. He should receive the ball on the 3-point level. That means that he should start under, because if he start from here, play defense on me, probably he is going out to receive the ball here. From this position, he cannot score. This is not his shooting range. So this is the first starting point. Under 14, under 12, you are going under. Okay, so next situation, let's say defender is in this situation, what technically we should do? First of all, I use free step getting open. First step with outside foot close to defender, because I want the contact. Second step, if it's possible, to put my foot in front of his foot. And third step, to go out, showing target hand. Always target hand is hand away from defense. And in the moment of the receiving, when I'm doing this, in the moment of the receiving, square basket being triple threat position, ready to shoot, to pass, or to drive. So this is the first technique when defender is playing like this, let's say open deny. When he is playing overplay full with hand on the passing line, of course I'm going to make backdoor cut. In this situation also with big guy here, I can do it. So my job is to go close to him, fake, because if I'm running like this, he's not going to react. If I'm going to show hand, this is just enough to make this, and I'm going to cut, changing target hand, and I should receive the ball. A mistake, young players, they are doing like this. They are changing here and going with circle move here. So like this, it's defender. We should go directly. I'm teaching players after backdoor cut to try to come in front of defender if you have advantage. So like this, I'm ready to receive the ball. It's not so easy, but definitely it's better to straight to the basket, then go to make move like this. Another situation, of course, this because here we have two players collaboration, so of course we should teach her how to pass the ball. I can make perfect cut, try to make cut, play defense on me. No, cut, play normally, play regular defense, come on. Play defense on me, make backdoor cut. Make backdoor cut, play defense. So, I cannot use two hands chest pass. I'm teaching players every time when you have defender in front of you, use one hand pass. Two hands chest pass, even in youth program. We can use only in open court in fast break situation. Every time when we have defender in front, we should make step away and of course on backdoor cut bounce pass. Okay, so this is the second way. Defense is going like this. If defense is playing overplay with strong physical contact on me, if I'm coming here, of course now I cannot make this move. I will make same move but with back pivot. Every time when you have straight contact with defender, when he push me, body check, hand check, back pivot, this is contact zone, as usually big players are doing under the basket. Okay? And the last situation, it's same like first one. If he play just deny with hand on the passing line, same technique. Go in, try to go over, receive the ball here, and immediately be ready to attack here. So this is first situation which I'm going to teach players, drills. 1-on-1 plus 1 on different positions, coaches. Basic drills. Believe me, I just get from Serbian coach Igor Kokoško, who is now first year out of America coaches, who become head coach of Phoenix Suns. I just get some drills from him. He is a good friend of mine. Every day, this kind of drills. 1-on-1 plus 1, close out here, close out here. So you don't need to find some special drill for this, but you need to find and you need to explain to players what they should do, how they should read defense in the right way. Okay, next situation, please go on the opposite side. Okay, next situation, how to get open, this is again moving without the ball, how to get open when I have a lot of space. Usually in modern basketball people are doing this for best shooter, best scorer, they are going to make isolation for him on the one side. Here we can use different techniques. First of all, teaching point for offense is when I'm going inside, play defense on me, when I'm going inside to receive the ball, I cannot go on the same line like inside. So inside and outside line should be different, because if I'm doing up and down on the same line, if I'm doing up and line, same down, without change direction, this is so easy for him to follow me. So teaching point here, when offensive player is going to get open, that he should make or V or L cut. So I can go inside, here I can fade on the side in the corner to receive the ball, or if I'm going from here I can make V cut to go outside, always same situation to receive the ball, or we can use L cut if you are going to start from the low post position. But mistake in L cut, what players are doing, follow me, they are coming here, they are doing this, they are pushing, of course this is foul, we don't want to do this. Teaching points, especially when you play away, referees against you, also lift your arms up and go one step inside. And after one step inside, go outside. Now I'm going to change my pivot foot is inside foot and I'm ready to attack. Of course, I can use L cut also the high post. I can go here, receive the ball here, fade in the corner. So all those techniques are regular technique. Only in situation when defender is not playing good, when he is staying under the basket, I can use I cut. So I can come to him and go back to receive the ball here. Because this is good, because after that I'm going to read close out. So in with good spacing to get open, usually those techniques are good. V cut, L cut, I cut, never go with same line inside, outside. Teaching points. Again, drills, 1-on-1 plus 1, coach here, coach here, coach in the corner, low post ball, get open over there. So you don't need to do something special for them, but we should find special explanation for young players when we are going to explain to them situation. Next problem, what to do when I receive the ball? So we are going, when I'm preparing clinic, when I'm preparing practices also for my players, I'm always thinking what is the next. Let's think that I receive the ball in some way here. Okay, now what to do? How to attack, how to read defense. Principle, teaching point for me, when I receive the ball on the ball, when I'm getting open on the ball side, I should first get open, receive the ball, read defender, and after that attack him. Of course, most of the time, especially in youth program, best way to attack is crossover step. So when I'm going to receive the ball, if I'm receiving like this, I'm going to attack here. But of course, smart defensive coach will say, no middle. What to do over there? In this situation, new rules helps to us to use zero step, to use open step, attacking immediately, basket. Okay, so when I'm going to receive the ball from here, I should push the ball, attack directly basket, and try to score. This is the how basketball game is flowing, let's say like this. Now, we are coming in the next situation, which happened again, I repeat, coaches, from mini basket to the final of the NBA. How to read first help? Because good players are reading well first help. Excellent players can read well second or third help. Let's start, because we are in the kids' garden, we are in under 14. How to read first help? Be in good defensive position. Ball is here, let me drive. Pass to me. So when I'm driving here, okay, what we should do? Now we start to teach driving kick. What you should do if I'm driving here? Can I pass the ball through to him? No, you should go here. You should go here. If he comes to me, I can make this bounce pass to you. My principle, probably wrong or right, you can decide for yourself, is every time when guards are going to drive, especially in youth program, to use bounce pass. Why bounce pass? First of all, defender who is coming to help, he has hands here. Look, I didn't say to him anything. So if I'm using direct pass, probably he can deflect pass. But definitely I didn't see in my life some defender who is playing defense here. So first of all, if I'm going here, he comes here, this pass he cannot deflect. Second reason, okay? Don't be good defender, let me make pass, okay? Let's go. If I'm driving here, if I'm making this pass, look, it's problem for big guys, especially in youth program, but also in top level. They cannot catch so easy direct pass. So also because of him, because I should think about my friend, he's my teammate. So also for you, it's too easy to catch the ball from that pass than direct. It's true or not? Say true, because if you're not saying, bad for me. Okay, so this is the next reason. Of course, in senior level, you can also make lob pass if he can dunk, but I prefer to teach kids in under 14, first of all, to use bounce pass. Okay? Next situation, if they close me well, stop me here, I don't want, because I cannot score from here. Personally, I don't like floaters. There are a lot of coaches who like this. I don't like, because I think that it's much better to use, if I'm coming here, if he's late, to use pull-up jumper to shoot the ball than to use floater. Because on floater, I can make also offensive foul. On floater, I cannot pass ball to her. But if I'm stopping on my drive, what you should do? Of course, so if they are going to stop me, perfect help, I always have safety pass outside or pass on opposite side. This is another situation which we are going to teach player with ball. Okay, talking about 101, this is advanced technique for under 14. If I'm going to receive the ball and if he is beside me, of course, what I should do in 101 technique? I can make step back to make separation, and when he comes to me, I can attack again, pass the ball or pass over there. So separation dribble, but not all under 14 players are ready to do this. So if when he is next to me, I want to separate, and when he comes, sometime he will come here, you can see great players to do this, to make this pass. This is not easy, but for talented players, in under 14, you can also teach them how to attack 101. Pass ball to her again. Another situation which we can teach also, guys, pass to me. If I beat you completely, stay here. If he is late, we can teach also up and under with front pivot, or if defender is good, come to me, or up and under with back pivot. All those finishing options we should run on the warp map, individual practices, everything, and after that with some two-on-two, three-on-three, to break down our offensive system and to use this when we are working with our. After that, I will show you some drills. So those situations are when we are going to what we should do when we are going to attack, when we are going to use the situation over the under the basket. Any question, coaches, for this? About this? Okay. Next situation, help side. What we should do if we are on the help side? Move you also on the help side, please, from the corner. Okay, I will show. Stay here. Ball is over there. We have now two players on the help side. Player in the corner, lady in the corner, and me. What I should do as a player on the help side? Usually what's happened with kids, mini basket, under 12, under 14, also with older group. Usually all the players are running to the ball. When they are running to the ball, 10 players here, probably in youth program, some injury happen because you have 10 players in 2 square meters. So we want to avoid this. Because of that, teaching points for help side offensive players is, first of all, to stay on the help side. So she and me, for us, is better to stay. Why? Because queen on the court is player with ball. If we are not staying on the help side, it's very difficult for her to drive. Now she can drive. That's right, you can drive. You can drive inside, outside, there is a big space. If they are going to help, very clear situation for her to read. But think about that, come in. If you are staying here, if you are coming here, very difficult. Very difficult for her, it's full, lane is full, she cannot drive. And another reason why we don't need to come inside, because if I'm staying here, stay you in the corner, show me your defense. Okay, you can sit down a little bit, what you should see. You are in good position, flat triangle, you should see ball and you should see me, that's right. You should look for me. But if I'm staying here, he don't need to look for me. Make hand check. You can just check me and you can look for the ball. So easy life for him. I don't want this. I want difficult life for him. So because of that, I'm going to stay on the help side. Of course, we have two situations when we are not doing this. First situation, when he's sleeping, when defender is in front of the passing line. If he is here, of course, I'm going to make flash cut to the ball and after read. If he comes to help, please go under. Okay, no, without dribble, when I'm coming, you should already be inside. Go back again. What you should read, this is coaches moving without the ball. When he comes to me, you should be ready to score. You should look what? What you are looking for when you are not over there. You look for your defender and look for the ball. So stay over there. If I'm cutting inside, come to help. When he comes, you should cut. All the levels. Mini basket, senior team. Of course, if he comes to help, do it again. Okay, stay up. I'm making flash cut. Of course, if he comes to help, I can pass to her to shoot or to make backdoor cut. So this is situation when I'm going to cut from the help side. Another situation when defensive player is pass ball back, please. When offensive defender is over the passing line, okay? When same for corner. We have not time, but same situation for you. If you stay under, flash to the ball. Flash to the ball, receive and score. Okay, normal for all the players from the help side. Pass back here. If defender is too much under the passing line, stay under. Of course, again, I'm going to cut. I can receive the ball, I can shoot, I can play one on one. But generally, as I said before, we should stay. Second rule. So first rule for help side, offensive players, stay on the help side. Second rule for me and for her, we should open passing line. So this, we don't need 200 kilos bench press to do this. We just need to see. So in this situation, stay where you are staying right now. He is on my passing line. That's right. So you can pass easily. Play defense over there. You cannot pass so easily because he is over there. So in this situation, my job, it's to move here, to open passing line, or to move under. So like this, you can see me well. That's right. Or if you have high post situations, stay you on the high post. Your offense, stay here. If I'm staying here, coaches, of course, this is not good because very difficult for you to pass to me. That's right. Very difficult. You cannot see me. But if she's under, I'm moving up. If she's over, I'm moving down. Same for you. It also, so second rule on the help side, open passing line. Okay? Third rule, go back in regular position. What I should do when I receive the ball? Usually what players are doing here? They are staying here like this. I'm teaching players to be practically in triple threat position without the ball, ready to attack in the moment of the receiving. Of course, I can show hand, and from this position, I can receive skip pass, to me, skip pass, or swing pass, pass to playmaker, and you pass to me. Quick swing pass, so I should be ready. Next teaching point, how to receive the ball. Coaches, we have different reasons, different ways. Pass to me. I can receive the ball left-right. Pass again. I can receive the ball right-left. Or I can receive the ball, pass to me. I can receive the ball just like this. Same from opposite side. Or I can receive the ball jumping to the ball in one contact. Some scientific research show that this last way, jumping to the ball, receiving the ball with one contact, it's faster than any other. And also, we have two more reasons why. First of all, because when I'm receiving the ball in one contact, pass to me, I'm putting energy, you know, I'm loading my legs with energy to jump or to drive left, right. This is the first reason. And another reason, very important for kids, pass to me. When I receive the ball in one contact without any problem, I can drive left, right with cross step, you know, I can avoid traveling. Okay, also with zero step today is a little bit easier, but from this situation, I can make cross step left, or, pass to me again, or I can make cross step right. So no problem for me to attack. So third rule for the help side, offensive players receive the ball in jump, stop, ready to attack basket immediately. How to read? This is very simple. Go over there. Be late with hands down. Pass to me. Pass to me. If he is late, of course, my read is to shoot the ball. He's down, legs, arms down. Okay. Pass again. Even if he is close to me, but with arms down, I should shoot. How I will score? Every day 200 shots. No other reason. Okay. If he's going to lift his right hand, pass to me. Right hand, I'm attacking opposite side. I'm reading. If he's going to lift his left hand, okay, I'm attacking here. Some coaches in closeout, they teach players to make closeout with two hands up. Can be. But I don't know, my experience, I was player 2 million years ago, and last 20 years I'm working as a coach, I never seen in my life player who is staying with two hands up and low legs. This is not natural position. So usually when players lift arms up, they extend knees. If they extend knees, they cannot react. Laterally, frontally, whatever. So another situation which is easy for offense, is if he is making diagonal closeout, if he is going with right leg and left arm, pass to me. If he is going like this, he is dead. So in this situation, if he is in this step, I can attack here. He cannot move laterally. That's right or not? Yes. You are out of balance. If I'm making good fake, I can send him in hospital with fake. So spine out. So we should teach kids how to read situation through the one-on-one drill, through all the situation. This is how to use help side offensive player. Same stuff which I said for the player over there, same for you. So you are help side offensive player, corner player, always same. I repeat again, stay on the help side. Second rule, open passing line. Third rule, receive the ball in jump stop and read and react according to the defensive position. Another thing which is different than on the help side, if you remember 10 minutes ago, I say that when I'm getting open, pass ball to her, get open and receive the ball. Okay, stop. One pass away from the ball, with on the ball side, what she should do? Get open, read and attack. When I'm on the help side, especially when she makes skip pass to me, during the ball fly, I should read. So now we have this situation, pass to me. Read, receive and attack. Because if I start to reading his position when I receive the ball, can be late. So because ball is flying over there, go in that position. So during the ball fly, I should see also what he is doing. So now order of my activities is read, receive and attack. So this is different. Ball side, one pass away, receive, read, attack. Here, read, receive, attack. And we should teach them, coaches, under 14. This is basketball. After that, in one day, we can teach them in under 16 flex offense or pick and roll offense or horns. This is not problem. But if they don't know how to read, if they don't know how to pass the ball, of course, very difficult for them to find good solution. Because always, as we talk in FIBA, also clinic, we have in basketball individual technique and tactic. That means all read, all situation, one-on-one. Group tactic, two-on-two, three-on-three, four-on-four. And team tactic, five-on-five. If we have not individual tactic, we cannot be effective, we cannot be efficient also in group and team tactic. And as Coach Pešić say always, so individual tactic and technique is for all career, and 5-on-5 is probably just for one game. And that is completely true. Some coaches from ex-Yugoslavia say to us, if you know to play 1-on-1, full court, offense, defense, so you are player. So in this situation, we are talking about individual tactic, how to read, how to react. Okay, next situation. Any question, coaches, here from this help side? Okay. Next situation, again, all activities without the ball. How to move in order to be ready to score when I receive. Because if I'm staying like this and waiting, this is easy for defense. We don't want this. Even if I'm going to move 1 meter, when defender go back, if he's not going or she's not going to find me here, go left, right, this is something. Better than do nothing. Next situation, after the pass to the low post. Go back over there. No, you stay in the corner, big guy go. Okay, now situation when we pass ball to the post. You can say, okay, under 14, we don't need post. Of course we need. We should teach kids from point guards to big guys to play on the low post. Why? Because of spacing, because we should prepare them for basketball in the next stages. Even point guards, how many point guards you can find that they're playing on the low post. So we should teach them. This is part of curriculum in under 14. All size to play under the basket. Why? Because most of the teams in top level, they are playing 4 out, 1 in. And why? Because we don't know if she will be 160 or 195. We don't know this. We should teach. More skills they have, better for them. So next situation of moving without the ball is when we pass ball to the post. Okay, do you? Pass ball to the post, what you will do? Okay, say what you should do. You're not going to play, what you can do? Okay, you can go in the corner, go. Okay, what you will do when she's going in the corner? Now we should explain to offensive player what defense can do and we should find opposite solution. Always opposite. Okay, go back. Pass ball back. Okay, pass to her. Okay, move. First of all, you don't need to wait. Okay, now you wait before me. Pass and cut. Immediately after the pass. Okay, let's stay first of all to explain. Pass and stay. Okay. What you can do, what you will do if she pass and if she stay? What you can do?
Wait.
Wait. For what? Ice cream? Huh? Nothing? No. Who is now God on the court? She is not queen anymore. She has not ball. She cannot score. That's right. Who can score now? Okay. What you will do to help to your friend? Okay. You will go to do like this. This is first option. Coaches, you know that yo-yo defense. Okay, you are going to help, be ready to react, help, because probably this guy, you put pressure on him. If he put the dribble on the floor, you are going to fake. Okay, in this situation, when he is like this, what you will do? Cut here or cut here? Why?
Because he's with...
Bravo, you're a smart player. So, for me, as a defender, move over there. If she move over there, pass to her, it's easy close out, because I don't need to change direction. Go back. Cut in the corner. Cut in the corner, I should rotate, I should find her. So, this is individual tactic. Of course, in higher level, we are going to teach when to cut according to your team offense, but individual technique and tactic is this. We always want to put back. So he cannot rotate and make good close out as he can without rotation, without changing direction. In this situation, she will cut in some other side. I don't like to go in the corner because this is easy. He go in the corner, pass. We like this defensively. So because of that, we don't want this offensively. Always opposite principles. Okay, and last situation, pass over there. Go to trap. Now you can choose. But only thing what she cannot do is to stay. Move somewhere. Now it doesn't matter. You can move over there, or you can move, you can cut, you can move. Just don't stay, okay? Be active. Why? Because he is not going to see you. So this is the situation when he trap. When we pass to the post, read. Attack back of defender. This is the principle. Okay, next situation, go back. We want to add some cuts. If he is staying over there, when we pass the ball, if you want to cut, of course you are not going to cut so close to him. Why? Because he should play one-on-one. So, my teaching point for players is to cut, to touch elbow when you are going to cut. So, from here, if I want to cut, I'm touching elbow and I'm going to cut, and here, I'm looking to the ball until the rim level, because sometimes happen that I have possibility to receive late pass, but I'm not ready. So follow me until here, and I'll stay. And now, sometime I can receive the ball because he say, okay, I bump him, I'm not going. So I'm teaching players until the rim level to look for the ball. If I cannot receive, of course, I'm going opposite side, I'm cleaning space for him. If he is on the high post, go in the high post. Of course, I'm not going to cut here. I'm going to cut under. First rebounding position is my target because of spacing. I'm cutting here. If you can pass, yes. If you cannot, nothing. I'm going, we are going to rotate. If player is staying on the middle post, second rebounding position, over there. Yes, I can cut under and up. You have different coaching philosophies. San Antonio, they are always cutting under. Pešić, Barcelona, he's always cutting inside. So, depends of you. Generally, I'm nothing in basketball, but I don't like to cut under, because if I'm cutting under here, he cannot play one-on-one. If I'm cutting here, it's not so good spacing for him. Okay, Duncan is waiting for Tony Parker. When he moves, he's playing. They are not so stupid. They can do this. But this is cut just to prepare for them something. So let's do like this. Stay on the low post. Pass to her. Pass ball and set screen for her and cut. Pass to him. Set screen for her. Come on, defense, play whatever you want. Okay, what defense usually will do here? Switch. So, because of that, usually this is guard, go back, guard me. So, after this cut here, after this screen here, I'm going to cut, she's going to replace me. Again, same principle, line and cutting over there on this basket. Of course, coaches, we have not time too much to talk about this. But in higher level, you can use the screens. So here, Fenerbahce, Real Madrid, what they are doing? They're making flare screen for shooter. Usually here is player position 4, pass ball, I will do. Pass to him. I'm going to set screen for Bogdanović. Look, problem immediately. I can shoot, Meli can shoot, or Slukas can shoot. So flare screen, this side. So can be split move, that when you pass, show both option. Now first pass and you set screen for her. You fake and go. Come on, pass to him, go to set screen, hop, go inside. Okay, you can see everything good except passing. Bounce, bounce, bounce. Defender arms are here, also big guys, but here, pass here. So second option, pass, and you set screen for her. Okay, don't switch defense. Don't switch, find, okay, okay, shooter alone here, pass the ball to shoot the ball. This is situation on the ball side. What we can do on the help side? On the help side, first of all, usually this defender is here. We should read situation from before. If he is under, I'm cutting to make flash cut here and to receive the ball. Stay in the normal position. Stay in the normal position, a little bit up. Be you under the basket, cut you. Cut you, try to pass to her. So they should read. With screens, we have different options. Pass ball to him over there. Stay in the corner. Three options which are good in under 16, under 14, a little bit tough for them. First of all, if he has the ball over there, you can set screen for her. Set screen. Go out, okay. What they will do? Switch. Easy for defense, okay? Let's do this, okay. But follow, don't switch. Pass ball to her to shoot, ready to shoot. Come on, let's go, cut, receive the ball, shoot the ball, okay? Next situation, now you set back screen for him. Go outside, okay? Come on, she set screen for him, pass to him. Again, sorry, pass to him. When he received the ball, you set screen for him. Okay, let's go. Hop, you set screen for him, pass, find man. This is second option. And third option, which is very effective in top basketball, you can see this probably for young players, very easy, but I think very good. So if he has the ball over there, who is player who is going to help on him? Usually you. Okay, in this situation you can see in top level that this player is going to set auto screen to lock his man and you are going outside to shoot. So ball is here, you are looking for here, I'm looking here, pass to her over there and this is easy shot, usually player position 4, always easy to shoot the ball, 2-3 doesn't matter. So those three activities are activities on the help side for kids. Of course, coaches, you have some special options. Pass ball to here, pass ball here, go back. Let's do like this. This is, I think, Israeli national team, if I'm right, Arik, say me if I'm right or wrong. What they are doing sometime, I saw this, Maccabi Tel Aviv with Coach Gershon, I think 6, 7 years ago, 10 years ago.
20.
Pass under?
20,
okay. You look so good. Same like 20 years ago. Okay, pass, okay. After this spot, cut inside and you set screen for him. Go outside, shooter to receive the ball. This is held side, but this is for a little bit advanced player. Or something what Žalgiris is doing last season for Pargo, very effective play. It plays is this. Okay, take the ball here. This player here, she is shooter. She is going to set screen here, back screen, you go under, and after that you set screen for me. I'm shooter, I'm going here. You play 1-on-1, but you are going to see me. But this is not for under 14. Definitely you have that option. So back screen, down screen situation. Of course, with experience, players are going to read. If they switch, they are cutting in. I don't want to talk about this. Key point. Help side and ball side, they should move. Even if they move 2 meters, it's better than stay. In youth program, this is starting point, which we should underline, and we should always insist on that. And now, when we finish this situation, we are going to talk about drive and kick. Okay, let's go outside five players, you know that. Go outside five players, okay. How to move without the ball? Circle move. Why circle move? Because circle move is different move of defensive rotation. Let me show you this. Okay, she is here, drive in the middle. What you should do? Bravo. Okay, go back. Go you to help, so you make backdoor cut, run in the corner, free throw line extender here. But key teaching point for kids, when they should start to move? In the moment when she drives. Not before, because Serbia said. They should read. On the first dribble in the middle, they should start to move. Okay, let's do like this, first option. Let her drive. What you should do when she drive here? Bravo, replace. So, drive you help, now first situation stay. Help and go back, okay? To explain to players more, of course, you are coaches, you know this. Just stay, often stay, drive, you help and recover. When I say stop, stop, come on, go, drive, stop, stop now. Look, close out. Close out here is now how many? 2 meters. That's right, easy for you. Especially for you, you are fast, you are mamba, pop up, you can go help and go back. Do the same, but now backdoor, sprint on the free throw line extension. When I say stop, stop, come on, go, drive, hop, stop. Look now, close out. Coaches, now is 5 meters. Which situation we want? We want offensively, long close out. Okay, let's say that she is shooter, he don't want to help. Go back, now you are just following, go you to help. Okay, you are doing always same stuff, come on, go, let's go, drive. Okay, no, just drive, we should show, just drive here. If he is going to help, who is free? Pass to him. Okay, you go to help, but move in the corner, come on, let's go, hop. He is going to help, easy pass over there. Okay, third option, go back, now you go to help. Drive to the basket, you go to help, you stay, because this is also best shooter in Belgium, you don't need to help, make backdoor cut, come on, you go to help, let's go, hop, bravo, bounce pass over there, left hand or right hand, depending on defender position. So circle move. Another situation here, with five out, this is starting teaching point. If she's driving baseline, drive baseline, you should stay in the corner, because we want to every baseline drive, we want to have shooter in the corner. You move elbow here, elbow extension, you are here. Perfect, you stay. You are on holiday. Okay, because probably he is not going to help, because you are Jasikevicius, you can score from the corner. So from the first pass, usually normal teams are not going to help. If they help, you can do something else. Okay, go back, pass ball to the middle, point guard. Drive and move. Okay, stop. Move. Come on, let's go, again. Move also you, come on. Move in the corner, let's go. Bravo, okay, super, go back. So they should move in the drive direction, again. Let's go, drive left. Bravo, okay, bravo, perfect. Then I first pass cut, do it again, go back. Corner ball, ball in the corner, drive baseline, move, okay, stop, corner, shooter in the corner, on baseline drive, we have one exception. Player from the corner, she is not going to move, do it again, you are on the free throw line extension, I will show. So on the baseline drive, we should provide 4 passing lines. Always baseline pass, so you are not moving. You are moving for one place. Here, elbow extension for you. No, now you are over there. When I'm driving, okay, here, if he comes to help, I will make this pass. She comes, pass to him. Who is the next? Pass to him. Very easy to read if you have good spacing. Okay? Okay. Now, on my drive, you come to help, you close baseline. Okay? So second pass is this pass. You go in the middle. Stay on your man. Stay on her. You can cut or you can shoot. So second pass is 45 degree pass. Third pass, go here. Okay, now go back. You go to help on me, you go to help on her, you go to help over there. So if I'm going here, third pass is 90 degree pass. Okay, you are alone to shoot. Now, white one, now you rotate to her. Now you rotate to her, come on. And last pass is safety pass. So if they are making full rotation, this here is safety pass. So those four passing options we should provide if penetration is over there. Next situation with one player inside. Low post. Okay. Okay, what we should do if how to teach big players or players who are playing on the low post. Very simple rule. In this situation when he is on the low post, let's think that we have imaginary line, post line. So this is imaginary line parallel with baseline, his level. Okay? When she is if she is going to drive here, what you should do? Bravo, come on, do it. He is going to help, go, stop, you go to help. Okay, come on, go to help, you just take and go back. So, big man or player position five. If penetration is go below, he is go up. If penetration is go up, you go below. Okay, let's show first option. Come on, drive here. Come on, stop. Bravo, super. Especially for position four. Opposite situation, I'm going to show instead of you. If she drives in the middle and if he is going to help on this drive, go, go. I just move one step away. Bounce pass, please, to me. So my goal, 2 meters to avoid to be close to him. I should look him and ball. When he move here, move to help, I move here. Look now, this is enough. So she will pass ball to me, pass to me, bounce pass. I'm going without dribble to score under the basket. So this is the situation when you have penetration here. Take the ball over there. Show me what you should do on the baseline. Stop, no, stay, stop, stop. You are here. Don't escape from contact. You can make money here, not outside. Okay? Come on, come on, let's go. Bravo, super, go back again. Okay, let her drive, you go to help, drop down. Find one of two players. First we start with three players because we want decision making, two decisions. After that with four and five. Okay, you should find who is free. Come on, go to help. You are here, this is your position, this is your position. When she drive, let her drive, go to help. Okay, bravo. This is first option. More over there. Okay, do it again. Now Simmons, try to close him. Pass in the corner over there. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Hop. Close. Just one hand. Shooter here. Okay, this is your job. Take the ball over there. Over there. Middle drive. Middle drive. Show me move. Stop. You can. But I think if you are five, it's better to go behind his back because we have shooter over there. Do it again. If you are good shooter, position four, drive. You can do also this, but I don't like because like this you are closing situation for her. Okay? So in this situation, when he drives, drive, you are going behind back, ready to receive the ball here. Okay, let's do this. You just stay, you are on the first pass, you cannot help. Come on, drive and find him. Hop it, go, but bounce pass. Okay, go back. Do the same, pass in the corner to shooter. Come on, let's go. She is alone, you can see spacing, you can see how long is close out. Okay, pass back. Baseline drive. Move, you stay. We are not going to help, if you help, you are out because she is shooter waiting for your help. So in this situation, baseline drive, you are in the corner, he is here, you just replace, do it again. Let him drive, drive with two dribbles and find solution. Come on, go inside. Who is alone? What's about him? Okay, both, but choose. Make decision. Not now. 5 seconds before. Come on. Come on, let's go. Let's go. Drive and find solution. Come on. Play like live game. Come on, let's go, let's go, let's go. Drive, who is alone? Okay, okay, bravo. Bravo, it's enough. So we are doing like this. So find solution. Every time opposite. Again, drive under the post line. Post is going up. Drive over the post line, short corner, up and down. Rules for them. Now we are going to run some drills. We have 25 minutes to run some drills to show you how to teach situation over there. Okay, let's make two lines one line here, give me free cones, come on. Run, when I'm saying free cones, you should run. Come on, let's go, free, I need just free. Everybody with ball, simple drill, shooting drill, drive and kick. Elbow extension. One group here, one group over there. And one more cone, please. One more cone. Put over there. Very simple shooting drills, but I like very much. I think that we should sleep with the drills. Put here. You are going to attack this cone. Okay, you are going to pass ball to me. Pass to me. Drive, sprint, drive and move. Pass to him. No, cone, in front of cone, over there. Pass to him, stop. How to pass? Of course, because defender is here, beside you. So, if you are going to teach your kids in under 10 to use outside hand pass, even weak side hand of the dribble pass, in 6 years, in under 16, she will be familiar. It'll be like eating pizza for her, okay? Attack this cone, left hand of the dribble pass. When you receive the ball, one dribble drive in the middle, jump shot. If he drive in the middle, you keep doing over there, run. I will pass, baseline, shoot. Okay, so you pass to him, and you are going over there, you make your shot. You will go to receive the ball here from me. You make baseline, dribble, jump shot, okay? Everybody, players, passers, left hand of the dribble. If you are making mistake, no problem. Okay? Let's go. Come on. Follow, pass, go over, go under, come on. Baseline dribble, in front of cone. Come on, next, in front of cone. Run, pass, go under, don't catch the ball, baseline. Come on, next, let's go, hop. Go, pass, follow, go, baseline dribble, shoot, come on. Pass, look for him, go under, let's go, shoot the ball, come on. Follow, wait for dribble, pass, go under, baseline, shoot the ball. Okay, next option, decision making. Now, when you receive the ball, you are going to attack baseline, one dribble shot, after this pass here, what you should do? Go back here. After this, if you see that she's going over, go back here, I will pass to you, shoot the ball from the free throw. Okay? Baseline, when you receive. Come on, let's go. This is second drill, let's go. Hop, a pass, pat, wait, you should wait. When you see that she's driving, you start. We don't want close to cone. When we are doing these drills, coaches, what is the typical mistake? They say, yes, coach, we know. And when they are driving like in handball, around 6 meters. Because of that, always I'm going to put the cone. I don't want him to drive here. I want you to attack basket. So, pop, pass, touch, and go out. Okay, just receive baseline drive. Let's go, come on. Together with him, pass, read, wait for her. When she moves, you start. Wait, hop, go, bravo, come on. Let's go, hop, drive, wait together, wait, go, up, come on. Let's go, pass to me, come on, hop, go, drive, baseline, shootable. Wait for him, come on. When he start driving, you move, wait, hop, you go out, bravo. One more time, let's go, hop, drive, pass, one hand pass, out. Okay, next drill, simple progression. Now you are going to read him. You can choose. you can go inside or outside. Middle drive, baseline drive, you're doing opposite. If he drive middle, under, if he drive baseline, you go out. Decision making. Let's go. Read, wait, hop, he goes out, bravo, come on, let's go, hop, pass, go, under, let's go, wait, wait for her, wait, 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 no, under, okay, after 10 minutes will be better, no problem, coaches, mistakes are part, one hand pass, under, let's go, okay, let's go, read, wait for him, hop, go, you go out, bravo, come on, okay. What you can do after? If you want to use this drill for something else, you can use this drill as a one-on-one drill. Sorry. Pass to me. Drive, drive, pass to her, close out one-on-one. Okay, you play live one-on-one game. Make bounce pass because we want to give you time to go back. Please move that cone out. So this is next drill which you can add as a one-on-one drill after driving kick. Come on, let's go, let's go, let's go. Faster, just one time to show and we are doing. You don't need my ball. Let's go, let's go, let's go. Hop, drive, pass, one-on-one. Game like. Every day we are going to do, every day we are going to do close out. Go, come on. Okay, so you saw the drill. Next situation, perimeter players, put that cone over there. Let's go one group of players under the basket, one group here, everybody with ball. Diamond exit, drive and kick, shooting drill. Okay, let's do like this. This group, you are going to pass ball to me, okay? Make fake, go to use the screen here, receive the ball. Okay, stop, pass, pass, pass. Again, coaches, how you will pass, Simpson? No, no, he's here, how you will pass? Yes. Okay, one hand pass. Okay, when he pass to him, drive in the middle, go over there, drive and kick, attack, attack, drive, pass to him, two dribbles, make, all right. Do it again. Pass to him. When you pass to him, go back here. I will pass to you, shoot the ball. When you receive, shoot. Okay? Let's go. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Let's go. Faster, faster. Come on, go. Go. No, no, go out. Ball is here. Your ball is here. Fake. Let's go. Wait for him. Drive. Attack. Pass to him. Go, go outside. Receive the ball. Shoot. Come on. Next. Next. Go under the cone. Under the cone. Come on, come on. Pass. Move. Dribble drive. Pass. Under. Receive. Shooting. Let's go. Next. Next. Come on. One time and we are going to change. Come on. Wait. Go. Drive. Right hand pass. Right hand attack. Right hand dribble. Let's go. Let's go. Come on, drive. Okay, wait. Another option. Another option. Sorry, take the ball. I cannot run. Pass ball to me. Do the same, but now when you receive the ball, baseline drive. Go, 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 you. Go, you. You're here. Pass to him. Baseline drive. Follow him. Stop. Pass ball to her. Sprint here to receive the ball from me to shoot the ball. Okay, everything same, just we combine. Catch and shot over there. Shooting drill for young players, also for senior players, why not? Come on, let's go, let's go. Full sprint, just couple of minutes and we are going to shoot. Come on, hop, pivot, bravo, go back, pass and shoot. Okay, super. Come on, next one, next one. Let's go, pass, wait for drive, hop, let's go. Okay, pass, move, move, sprint here, shoot the ball. Con, use the screen. Of course, coaches, here you can add shot fake, drive fake, change of direction before to attack, different passing techniques. This is up to you after that how to develop drills. Next situation, very important for small and big guys. Let's be all the big guys under the basket over there, all the guards here. Be you big because we have not enough. Okay, one, two, three, four, super. Stay here. Let's make one player offense, one player defense. Who is defense on her? Come on, play you defense. Play you defense. Let's go. Play lady. Game-like situation, game-like drills. Okay, stay on elbow extension, pass to me. Okay, I'm going to pass ball to you. When you receive the ball, attack, read. If she drive baseline, what you are going to do? Here, baseline here. If she drive here, you're a big man. Okay, you should score under the basket. Be ready, be ready, be ready. Come on, attack, come on, drive, move. Okay, let's go. Again, next one, next group, just change. We are moving without the ball in 1-on-1, pass to me. Okay, let's stay a little bit here to give handicap to him. Okay, when you receive the ball, attack, baseline or middle line, defense over there, you stay, defense over there, you should see the ball. Come on, go, go, attack, move. Okay, good idea, no problem, passing technique. Jump a little bit more to me because we want to create handicap. Come on, bravo, bravo, okay. So you can see after 10 minutes, they are doing well. Next situation with three players. Come on, two players over there in the corner. Two big players here and guards here. We have one exception of circle move, coaches. Let's come here. We have one exception of classical circle move. Pass to me. If happen, usually that happen on the middle, on the from the top of the key, when drive is come from the top of the key. If she is driving here, you will come to help, you go here to help on him. Now you are moving up. This is the only situation when player from the corner is going to move up because he should replace himself to be ready to shoot the ball. Because on this deep help, come to me, deep help, moving here, and this is your position from which you can shoot. So in most of the situations, player from the corner is staying or moving backdoor cut, but in this situation when helps come late, he should replace himself to open passing line over there. Simple drill, pass to me. Okay, or we can add something which, okay, let's do this first. Okay, be ready to react. Live game, okay? Live game. If she's driving here, what you should do? Bravo. She drives here, up. Okay, ready? Stay in the corner, stay in the corner, stay in the corner. Come on, go, go, drive, 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 hop, move. Okay, help from the first pass. They will teach after that how to read. Come on, again, again. We have not enough time. Let's change position now. Okay, let's be you now here. Coaches, according to your needs, you change positions. Low post help side, low post ball side. Low post help side, shooter in the corner. Low post help side, shooter on the free throw line extension. So it's up to you. After that, I'm usually doing after this fast break drills. So free against free here. After that, who missed the shot or who score, touch, free against 2+1, free against 2+1. Free against 2+1, jump over the hardless here. So after that, we can create situation. Now let's make drive from this side. Stay you on this side. Okay. Stay you on this side. Be ready to react. We know what we should do. What you will do if he drives in the middle? In the middle. Okay, come on. Play. Drive in the middle. Okay, you stay. I don't want you to stay. Or backdoor cut or lift up. Read defender. 10 minutes I have. Huh? Well, I have 10 minutes more.
Five.
Okay. Okay, pass to me. Always less. Come on, let's go. Again, again, pass to me, again, pass to me. Hop, again, hop, drive, move. Bravo, that was better. Okay, okay, finish, change offense defense, change offense defense, just to show this. Again. Be ready, let her drive, because you're faster, let her drive, okay? Go, go, drive, attack. Okay, we should read, stop, stop. Okay, he's not big man, but I don't want you be in the middle distance. You are cutting or here to score over there, or if you think that you are shooter, you are going to escape here on the middle range. This is nothing. Okay? Decide. Do it again one more time and we are going to run last drill. Pass to me. Come on. Let's go. React. React. Bravo. Good read. Okay. Not bad. Pass here or pass here. And this kind of drills which I like very much. Let's make 4-on-4. 4-on-4, come you here, be you offense, be you defense. One player here, shooter in the corner, top of the key here. Let her go over there, you move here. Go out, 4-on-4. Handicap situation, this is excellent drill for defensive rotation and excellent drill for driving kick game. We can do it that way. Stay here in front of him. If you remember yesterday on the practice, we make this. You are not going to look for me. I'm going to show hand to give handicap for defense or advantage for offense. Okay, move ball outside. Thank you, Michael. Okay, just stay here. If I'm going to show you this hand, you're going to touch me here. Touch me. In that case, you drive here. Okay, if I'm going to show here, you touch here. I want to see circle move. Okay? If he drives here, what we will do? Here, backdoor cut, corner, move. If he is driving baseline, stay in the corner, you cut here, move, move. Nothing else. Okay? Make decision. This is handicap situation which always happen. Come on, specific. Let's go, one more time, just to show to coaches and we are finished. Come on, let's go. Okay, okay. Of course, after that, you as a coach, you decide before to start running that drill, you should make defensive principles. Who is going to rotate? Baseline, of course, big player under the basket. Middle, drive. You want to switch, you want to help and recover, or you want to play from the last. This is up to you. You can develop according to your philosophy. But game-like drills. And after that, when they finish here, always coaches transition. Transition, 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 transition. You can add also some situation I'm doing like this in practices. I'm starting from this situation, and I'm playing four handicap here, four against three plus one, four against three plus one. After that, four against four, four against four. If you are going to play with five players, same drill, different options, drive from the corner, from free throw line extension, from top of the key, I'm running five against four, up and down. Five against five, man to man, five against five, zone. So six courts together, this is so difficult for players, so effective from condition point of view, and so effective if you are looking for decision making, because they cannot be focus on mobile devices, they should be ready to react and read. Of course, this situation we are smiling, but we are crying on the practice every day because of that, because to repeat 20 times same stuff, they are doing bad. I should say that group was good, so they demonstrate well. Bravo, thank you very much for your time. Probably because we made yesterday similar practice, so they are better today than yesterday. Congratulations. Talented players are learning fast, so you should be like this. So thank you very much for your time. Of course, if you have any question, I'm here. Shut. Thank you very much. Thank you very much.